Welcome. This is a recording of adults playing or talking about tabletop games. This means that adult language and or themes may occur within that could be seen as inappropriate for younger audiences. Thank you.
Okay. So, you all are led into the hidden entrance to Arlington Station. First thing that you guys would notice, this would be more something that Roland would notice, being an older one. Same with you, actually, Flowers. You're actually a little bit older. You should be late 30s.
I'm at least 40. I'm like 40.
Yeah, Roland's 40s. 40s, but you're 30s, Nate, right? Flowers is? Because he was SWAT before the whole incident, and it's 13 years after. So you would have had to have been mid-20s to late-20s minimum, and then add 13 years on 30. Top of that. So, late-30s. Okay. So, the first thing that you realize is that you feel like you're in a doctor's office. There's, like, these, like, very, like, phosphorescent, like, light bulbs that kind of add that really pale, flat white to everything inside. Almost science lab, forensic lab kind of feel. And it seems to go that way. And almost immediately, as most you guys have noticed from most entrances and exits of stations, it begins to go down. But the entire thing is very well lit, to the point where it's almost blinding in nature, and you progress down. The next thing that you notice is that there's almost no guards anywhere in the facility.
That's foreboding.
And you can immediately tell from the reactions of Abigail that she's kind of like looking around and kind of like getting unease, and her hands start twitching kind of closer to her guns. This is probably something that's not supposed to be.
Can I roll a performance check? Or not performance, perception check?
Absolutely. What are you looking for?
Can you just roll that?
Roll both anyway.
Anything relatively out of place? Just...
Sure. Give me that roll.
If I could find it.
Go.
And that was without my focus.
So it's actually a 22?
Yeah, I forgot to click the thing.
Okay, no problem. I'd say that what you feel is not that there's something out of place, but it's the sheer lack of nothing is out of place that feels odd in what you're seeing. Everything seems perfect. Like, for there not being security, like, even your station, which is not the most, like, guarded and highly, like, related, there's guards fucking everywhere at entrances. Because if an initial push comes in...
What does he notice about the guards? Like, do they seem...
There are none.
...out of sorts? Well, but didn't you say there were a couple?
No, I'm saying at your original station, at an entrance, particularly because, like, just because yours is a warlike station.
But there are none here.
There are zero. And especially considering the Chaos Gate is right the fuck outside, like, you should have seen someone at this point. And that
I'm going to draw my sword.
Okay.
Do I notice any cameras or anything, or just sheer nothingness?
There's no cameras or anything like that, but like, it's just that there's nothing wrong. Like if you'd expect that there would be a guard there, then you'd expect human beings. But there's not human beings when there should be human beings. But there's nothing to tell that a human being was removed from these locations. You know, it's not there's blood everywhere.
They're just magically gone.
They're literally, it just feels like there should be human beings in this area, and there aren't. And while nothing is wrong with that, it just feels wrong to to you.
I.
And the, it's kind of like that, like, where, like, you don't know what's wrong, but all the hairs on the back of your neck stand up, and all your muscles kind of tense so that you can spring in any direction at a moment's notice if you need to. Your body's, like, kind of feeling that adrenaline ready to flood your system. It's that kind of feeling from you. Like, you just have that. The rest of them are kind of uneasy, but, like, you are literally, like, ready to jump out of your skin, freaked out by this oddity. And you're not sure why, but you kind of get that feeling. It's like, it's kind of that, it's quiet. It's too quiet. It's kind of that feeling to you.
Gotcha.
Like, it's completely silent in there. The only sound that you hear from anything, there's no machines whirring. There's, you know, no beeping. It's just pure silence and you guys breathing and moving. The normal, like, chink of you guys moving around, a gun slapping against the side of your leg kind of thing. Like, that's the only sound in this entire hallway.
I need to roll to see that there's something wrong and draw my sword, or can I just know that it's weird in general and just kind of creep along suspiciously
sort
out?
If you're going to be, like, thinking that you're going to, like, go to the point of actually drawing weapons, then I need you to roll a perception to feel that that's what you need to do. But as to, like, feeling that things are weird, at that point you still kind of feel that, like, this is weird, but, like, you're not quite to the point of, like, holy shit, I need to fucking draw my weapons kind of feel.
Okay,
but you're, like, right near that point. Exactly. Yeah, like, she's kind of got her hands ready to draw at any moment. That's probably where you are. You could maybe, like, rest your hand on your hilt kind of thing. You know, like, something like that, and you're kind of, like, looking around, like, this isn't right. But, like, it hasn't gotten to the point where you're just like, wacha! You know, kind of thing.
Alright, no wacha.
No wachas. And you guys proceed down. You also, as you proceed down, there's multiple checkpoints where there would be more guards. There's actual, like, seats for people to sit and, you know, blockades and stuff that lead down where they can actually, like, close off. So you guys know this is actually more like a submarine where they kind of have, like, these points where they can close and lock off an area or multiple areas. Like, you can lock off, like, both areas and quarantine a section. And this goes down for a period of time deep underground. However, all the doors are open and there's no guards at any of these points. This is the point where everyone knows that something is absolutely and horribly wrong. You do not need a perception check. You all are at the point that Zeke is at now. This is Resident Evil, didn't you know? We literally stepped into Resident Evil.
You can say that out loud, dude.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't want to interrupt this flow, but I didn't want to forget.
No, you're fine.
Oh, I do it all the time. Don't worry about it.
It's part of the fun.
You used to it by now.
And then after, let me stop me at any point. So you're progressing through these checkpoints, walking through seemingly open doors, no people. There's nothing that says, like, anyone just suddenly disappeared. There's not, like, a plate of hot food just sitting there waiting, you know, and nobody to, like, say that someone was just there. But, like, literally there should be guards here. I mean, it's blatantly obvious that there should be guards at these checkpoints, and there's not. And as you proceed through, you finally reach the last checkpoint, and the doors are actually shut at this checkpoint specifically. As you reach this point, behind you, you hear the lights that they're, you know how, like, lights have that hum sound? That, like, slight little buzz. You realize that sound was actually always existing. Because it's just kind of one of those white noises that you guys always forget. And it slowly seems to get quieter. And I need a hearing check from everyone.
Which is also perception?
Also perception.
Yep.
If you have hearing, okay, you get a bonus.
Well, fuck. Apparently I'm deaf.
What? Did you say something?
Correction, Ren is deaf. Ren's still chuckling at our inside jokes. Roland and Zeke, you actually hear that sound, and then you hear kind of like a switch kind of sound, like a tick, tick, tick,
tick. Oh, that's never a good sign.
And when you do, you guys both turn around and you see that at the end of the hall, like down through a couple of the porthole areas, the lights are actually being shut off. Like far down, moving towards you.
I pull out my flashlight.
Okay.
This is like Dead Space style of spooky.
Yeah.
I will also pull out my flashlight and tape it to my shoulder. Like in Dying Light.
Okay.
It's duct tape to my shoulder.
So you guys kind of see that like Zeke's like suddenly rummaging in his bag and he pulls out his flashlight and you're like, what the fuck? And Abigail looks at her and I'm like, what the fuck? And then she looks over her shoulder and she sees the lights going out and she's like, that's not going to be good. At which point she just takes her fist and she starts slamming on the door. And she's like, let us in now. And there's no response from the other side. What do you guys do?
Do we see any visible means of opening the door? Or is it just two sheets of sealed door?
Two sheets of sealed door and a keypad to your left.
Okay, I don't know the code.
I'm gonna be like, is this door important? Is it structurally important?
She just looks at you and glares.
I'd like to roll an.
I want to punch the door open. Or kick.
Isn't
the door
it like solid steel?
Yeah, it's solid.
I don't know. Oh, so I wouldn't be able to do that.
You can try
at all.
I guarantee you'll break your hand.
Well, I mean, like if I try to kick it open or something.
Go ahead. Give it a good firm kick. I don't mind. What's that, Zach?
What? Can I roll anything in relation to the keypad to see if I can...
That would be an intelligence computer check if you were trying to hack it.
I don't have a lot of intel, but why not?
Man, it'd be great to have Biscuits here.
I tried to kick the door. Did it open?
While you gave it a very resounded and hearty kick, the only thing that prevents your toes from breaking is the steel mesh that covers them.
There's a nice dent in the door now.
Isn't it like a blast door?
Yeah, it's basically a blast door. Like, to give you an idea, like, if anyone's seen Star Wars Return of the Jedi, or even A New Hope, how they have those giant, like, doors that they, like, climb through while the lasers are all firing at them. It basically looks like one of those big fucking doors.
I kind of think whatever's on the other side of this door is worse than whatever's coming towards us, so I just got my sword out.
Okay, so you're drawing your sword. Awesome.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with I failed that miserably.
Yeah, so basically you gather that there's only two options on this keypad. There's a 9-digit passcode to get through. And there's an intercom button. That's what you get from this. As far
I'm gonna
as
push the intercom.
I'm pushing the intercom button.
Okay, so you quickly hit the button for intercom. What do you say?
Hello.
Service.
Well, shouldn't
no
we
matter what I say,
talk,
no matter how much I plead, do not open this door.
Shouldn't it be Abigail or Kiro, since this is a Templar facility?
Or you. You, sir, are a Templar.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
We're sitting outside this door, and lights are systematically going out. We could, we would like to come in, please.
You hear a...
three Templars.
You hear a... and then you hear a voice go, do you say the lights are coming out, going out?
Yeah.
Sorry, but we're not opening the door.
And then you hear at this point, I would like to turn my gun towards the hallway.
Okay. At which point, the sound from the intercom, that kind of like that kind of crackly radio sound that was coming from the intercom, goes silent. The other line shut its comm off. At this point, you have about 2 porthole areas before the shadows or the darkness encloses around you guys.
Can we tell if the lights are actually just turning off, or is it like magical darkness?
It seems like the lights are actually flicking off.
Are there like vents or anything that like we could
crawl away? There are very, very small vents, about yay big, in the tops that supply air to the hallway, but that would be it. This seems like if that outside door from the crypt area was breached, this absolutely is a stage area for basically if demons were to come through here, they'd have to face a firing line style type combat, and they'd have to breach every single door down the way.
I want to do a communication check.
On?
On the intercom. I want to hit the intercom, and I want to say, we got 3 Templars out here. We have enough time for you to let us in, and it'd be a bad idea to let 3 people die because you're a pussy.
I love it. Please roll me... Okay, so that'd be...
Maybe
somebody
insulted him.
Does he get a hero point?
Yeah, right? No, that would have been a hero point in the last
We should have, a little secret scoreboard, like...
The Krillinone count.
Yeah. At that point, you hear... there's, like, this kind of, like, pregnant pause, and then you hear... as metal is shifting inside the door, and the door begins to open, and it actually kind of does like literally like it like shifts in these 4 different patterns away to cause like kind of a diamond shape. Can't, there we go. Herk,
turk, turk. Be like, everybody in.
I'm in.
Okay. Almost immediately, as it reaches the point where you guys can start to climb through. You guys start like literally like diving through the hole, and as you do so, the door actually hits reverse and starts closing again. I would like to know the order of people that go through. Abigail is going to be last.
She's dead.
I feel like my character would try and usher everybody through and go second
to
last.
Okay, so you're second to last.
That's a bad idea.
I will go first.
Okay. Flowers, you were pretty into getting through, so I'll say you're second.
I'll go second first, yep.
Second first.
Actually, he can go first. I'll go after him.
Okay.
Ren, I'm going to look at then. Abigail and be like, get in!
She just, like, stares at you for a second, and she's like, fuck it, and she dives through the hole. I need a acrobatics check from Ren, since you are second to last. And then,
what is that under?
Acrobatics would be your dexterity.
Dexterity? Oh shit, I have a focus! Oh god!
Oh, I'm dead.
Your training with Asian parents has taught you Chinese circus tricks. And
I try and pull Roland in after me? Like, after I roll it, get
in? No, because you're literally, like, diving through this tiny little space. To get through, because it literally
right,
like opened.
But I'm talking about as Roland.
No, because you're diving
in,
through. You're not gonna have time to like come out of your somersault, turn around, and be like, "Oh, here, let me help you." No, not having the time. Roland.
Yeah. Did I get like cut in half by the door?
Give me your roll. I will say that this is to figure out if you think you can. First.
And what am I rolling?
This is an acrobatics.
I thought you
check.
Already rolled.
Yeah, I got a 13.
Yeah. Yeah, that's
so
not enough. So you're yeah. about to dive through and you realize that you're not because you're big and Ren was, you know, Ren's a big woman. But your shoulder girth is almost the same as hers, huh?
I'm tall.
She's tall.
Well, how
that's a big woman.
How tall is she?
6'5" or 6'7". What did we decide?
You're 6'7".
You should really just write this down.
You're like
she's 3 inches taller
than her. I have 6'5" written down, but I'll change.
But You're as a already, like you said, you're like 6'4". That's a very tall male. I mean, that's a little bit taller than me. And your girth, especially considering that you're like military and you carry a sword and a shield and shit.
Got like shoulder pads and shit.
Yeah, you got shoulder pads and everything. You know that you're not gonna fit through that door. It would crush a portion of you and possibly remove a limb if you tried.
All right, I'm gonna turn around, square my shield up, and okay. Wait for what happens.
And you guys see as he kind of like goes to look through and stops, and then just turns around and hunkers his shield down, and you see the doors.
Can we open the door again?
I'll be right back with Roland. I'm gonna tell the guys what's on the other side of the door, and then I'm gonna tell you what happens, Roland. Get through the door, you can see that this area is also brilliantly illuminated. But where the hallway had like these top-down lights, all around the door are almost like spotlights facing the door.
Oh.
These giant lights, like, you know, super lumen sea planes in the sky lights pointed at this door.
I'm glad I'm wearing sunglasses.
It's not dark in here for you to wear sunglasses. And you guys are essentially blinded by this light. What are you guys gonna do? You're trying
to roll a performance
see
check.
If performance check from you, okay. Flowers, you said you were gonna look for a way to unlock the door for him?
Yeah.
I need a seeing check for you to be able to see through this brilliant bright light.
Perception.
Oh, no. Balls.
I can't see through at 13? Fuck.
I mean, that's pretty good for like a medium type thing, but this is extremely difficult to see through.
I'm gonna turn around and do the same if that's okay. Like try and get the door open.
Sure.
Or yell. Give me like, another... down the hall, like, get the door back open!
Which one do you want to do?
That
was to see, you know. So apparently you are blinded. Those green sunglasses.
I'll be blinded and be like, open the door back up.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine, but they don't do shit about it. What was that? Did you roll your performance?
No, I have not.
Give me your performance.
Ugh. Darn.
Wow.
Buttons on your
What song Triple were one. You going to have played?
Blinded by the Lights.
So you go to try to play Blinded by the Light, but those giant lights seem to accentuate the awesomeness of your saxophone, and it's nice, you know, shiny hue that you've taken care of this instrument with. You know, you've actually managed to find polish in this post-apocalyptic world to polish your sax. And the light really shows it, and your own saxophone blinds you, and you can't perform.
Sound like a little bit like that dog, I'm thinking.
Yeah, yeah, it sounds exactly like that dog.
Rex, you're pretty loud.
You shut your mouth. You shut your mouth.
Hey. Okay. Roland, as the gate finally closes, it creates a small beacon of light, and when it does, you can see a seemingly gray creature walking towards you. Long, lanky arms with fingers that extend probably twice what a normal human's would, and knees that bend backwards.
That thing?
What bends backwards?
Yep.
The knees. Instead of bending forwards, like the joint at the knees bending forward, it bends the opposite direction.
Can I roll to try and light up my holy sword?
Absolutely. I need a faith check from you.
Holy sword.
What do I do?
Faith check. Wisdom. If you have faith, you check the focus button.
Isn't it willpower?
Yes, willpower. My
yeah.
Name. Wisdom, willpower.
Hey.
Absolutely.
That's good, right?
Wah.
Sweet.
So your sword, what kind of position do you take with that? Are you doing kind of a more of a Spartan pose, or you have like your sword back, or
No, I'm thinking kind of hunkered down, shield forward, sword up, and ready to go. Okay. Not like.
So you're ready for like a push and then a swing kind of motion?
Yeah.
Okay.
Defended and ready to hit.
What kind of sword is it?
A bastard, like a bastard sword.
It's a big, big sword.
It's essentially a sword that's intended for two-hand use, but can, if you're strong enough, use it for one-handed use.
Right.
And I have as big of a shield as John will let me have within the rules of the game.
Which is a pretty big shield.
Like a half-plate giant shield.
It's a...
A tower shield?
Well, tower shield's a really medium. Big. It's a medium shield. Yeah. This is something you guys would have seen. It basically is like ass cheek to shoulder size that he would wear on his back.
So like a Spartan size shield.
Spartan is bigger. Bit. Like that would actually is be it? A large shield. There's his calf so to probably... shoulder.
Oh, okay. That's like a tower shield. All right.
Well, that's actually called a targe. And that would be the maximum size. There's no such thing as a tower shield in this game. No one actually would carry a fucking tower shield.
Right, no, I know. I'm thinking in D&D terms.
Yeah, like... it would be a targe. T-A-R-G-E. It's basically calf to shoulder.
Okay.
So you do that, and when you do that, the holy light pushes back out into the darkness a little bit right when the light that's above you turns off. And you can see at the edge of your vision this creature stand there and look at you and just kind of like look around and kind of pace left and pace right around the light, trying to figure out if there's any, it kind of like testing the darkness and light barrier that you've created.
So it seems like it can't physically pass past my light?
It seems to be doing something like that.
But it might just
kind of like the Cerberus that we fought?
Cerberus was able to be in the light, it just didn't like the light.
But it, like, created its own darkness around it, didn't it?
No. That was the Inquisitor creating the darkness.
Oh.
Do you have to hold down the intercom to talk, or can they still hear
you? Yeah, you gotta hold down the intercom.
Okay. Open up. So I'm just standing out there, light up, and it's kind of testing the edges of how far it can get.
It's kind of like looking around, and it's almost like feeling it, almost like miming, like a wall, you know, like...
I want to take a real small step forward.
When you do, it kind of shrinks back, it takes a step back, it kind of matches you. But it's always like kind of touching and feeling and poking. And you can see these like spindly fingers, I mean, to give you an idea, like, I got big hands, but like its fingers are about that long.
Okay.
And it's kind of like feeling, and you can see that they're kind of like warp and twist, and when you do, you can actually see that the joints in the fingers move uniquely so that the fingers actually can bend sideways too. It's not just like forwards and backwards, they can actually go left and right too. So they're almost tentacle-like.
Can I kind of hit the intercom button with my elbow and keep the sword up?
If you step back, you could.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, I meant that I just kind of shuffled forward just far enough to see how you, so I'm still pretty close to it. I want to say through the intercom, I have some, I'm assuming, demonic entity that is kept back by my light. Can I maybe get through?
Open the door, please.
Like for the moment, it can't get to me. So if I get through and we hit the door while my light's still up, it won't be able to get through to us.
So the three of you, you hear that the crackling sound from the intercom on the other side. And,
can we, light up the area as well? Or I'll look at Abigail and say, hey, okay. Use the rosary to light up this side as well.
Shit, yeah, I want to ask her to pull out her sword and light her area up so that when you open the door, there's double holy light keeping it back while I get through.
So you're telling that to Kiro?
Yeah.
Well, I was going to say that to Abigail, like,
well, then, when yeah, he all three says, of us
like,
are...
I've got a light going... You know, and I'll be, if it's a demonic, if he says it's a demonic creature, I'm going to be like, hey, bust out, you know, holy light, like with the rosary or whatever you use. I don't know what she uses, so.
She looks at you and she says, the rosary has been expended for the day, and I don't carry any holy weapons on me.
She doesn't care at all that the dude she showed up
no,
with.
No, she
is,
says,
like,
I don't carry any holy weapons on me.
No, I know, it's just, she seems real calm.
She's calm, yes. She's very calm.
All right, I want to continue to admonish.
She then looks at Ren, she looks at you, and she says, do you have one?
I really don't want to bust out the greatsword right now.
Now, are you metagaming that? Because you've heard that she was inspecting your sword, or are you... Is that something you would truly do in the case of one of your Templar allies?
Well, I don't want to reveal that also in that tunnel, I guess. Because it's sort of like we don't know who's in the base as well.
True.
Because it could be Templars, but it could be someone else that, like, took over.
Very true.
Came along. I'm going to look at Flowers and be like, can I borrow the longsword? Because I gave that back to him, I think. Or do I still have that?
You gave that back to him. Because you were carrying the two girls, so you offloaded a lot of your supplies, including the great, the longsword.
Okay. I'll ask for the longsword.
Okay. Flowers, I assume you give it to her? Or would you like to faith check to try to cause the sword to...
Oh, there's no fucking way. There's no fucking way. I'll roll negative somehow.
Okay.
So I probably should just use the greatsword because the longsword's easier to hide, but whatever.
Your choice. So I will use personally, I'm kind of questioning why you wouldn't draw the greatsword. Honestly, why would you ignite one sword and not the other?
Can I change my mind? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll just say okay, and then I'll bust out the greatsword.
Okay.
Can I do the faith check on it? Or?
Absolutely. I need a faith check from you.
Hey.
That does it.
Okay.
The orange fire licks up the blade and begins radiating from it. I forgot to ask, Roland, what color is the flames on your sword?
Does it have to be flames, or can it just be like light?
It could be a light. But I would need a color as well. Holy like Christian magic seems to radiate white.
Yeah, I wasn't even really thinking holy Christian magic. It's just kind of like...
Well, I'm
like
just telling you, brightness. That's the color that holy Christian magic is.
Oh, okay. Well, then I want mine to be dark. Or no, it's a bright light.
Black like my soul.
Yeah.
he wants a moderate gray.
So like slightly off-white? Can I go like hot pink? If you want.
No, I'm not doing hot pink.
You
no.
just want like an off-white, like kind of a eggshell-ish?
Hey man, it's lime green!
It's the antithesis of like demonic, like it's just kind of like pure looking. Like I wanted to really freak this dude out, like this demon that's kind
of
testing it.
Okay,
like,
the reason I ask this is this is always going to be what your color of the blade is when you do this.
Yeah, I don't want some crazy hot pink shit. I'm happy with just pure bright light.
Okay, so we're going to say that it's more kind of like your average with a slight yellow to it then. Kind of like a holy glow, like the, you know, classic holy glow of Christian angelic yellowish white. We'll say that it's that then.
That's fine.
It's more pure white.
Huh?
I was thinking
halo yellow versus like, you know, Messiah white. If I was going to add Crayola colors to whites and the Christian faith.
I was going to say it's like a weird Christian Crayola color.
Coloring with Jesus book? Yeah.
Coloring with Jesus. So what would my color be then? The orangey, reddish, auburn color, I guess.
We'll come back to that, but I kind of know the color.
Calvin and Hobbes orange.
Calvin and Hobbes, yeah.
I was thinking that Ren's is kind of like an angry, like wrathful light.
It's a very angry, harsh yellow.
Mine is just kind of like a calm, like, yeah.
Yours is a little bit softer.
Yeah.
Okay. And a lot more white. Okay. It gives off this hue. Ren, yours bursts into this very much extremely fire is licking up this blade. And unfortunately, when you hear that voice, it actually comes over like speakers into the area. And not over like your actual, like it's not like a button, you know, a speaker right next to the intercom area.
Oh, we can't press the button and be like...
Well, you can. It seems like you can, but... What you're kind of gathering from that is that whoever originally opened the door should be standing right next to you, but no one is actually there. You hear just kind of this area.
They like
area that Flowers saw with the area to try to, like, open it, and there's no one obviously there. What do you guys do when you hear this, you know, when you hear Roland's voice come over the intercom?
Is there a green and red button somewhere that's, like, open?
I'm just gonna switch. I'm gonna yell, open the door.
Okay. No response. Still blinding light. Roland, and you guys actually would hear this too. You hear a raspy voice come over it. Coming out of the darkness. Roland, you actually see the thing. Its jaw unhinges a little bit and it's talking. I'd probably say that its jaw kind of does like almost an oval kind of look when it talks. And
it just opens and it's doesn't open
no,
and close?
No, it opens and it opens and closes, but like when it opens, it you get the feeling that it doesn't know how to pronounce English properly to you.
Okay.
And so like it has to like keep readjusting its mouth to make the words that it's trying to say to kind of shape the sounds. So it always tries to open its mouth all the way and then it has to like readjust and close. And it starts telling you, hello, mortal.
Is it going to mess up the story if I step forward and take a swing at him as he's talking?
Go for it.
All right, as long as that's not stepping on your toes. Yeah, I don't like that shit. I'm going to step forward and take a swing right into his face.
Too spooky for you.
So you hear it say, hello, mortal, as its jaws kind of do this. And you just kind of do like a quick... Is it like a test swing or like you're full on going after
it? No, I'm going for it, yeah. Okay. I want him to be distracted as possible and I just want to swing right at his face.
Okay, roll me to hit.
Holy sword macro, right next to the six. Okay. Ew.
15. Good roll.
Yeah.
Doesn't hit, though. Okay.
Oh, shit, that's spooky.
Oh, dang.
Yeah, that was a good roll. Good roll, but it doesn't hit. As you go to swing, you can see that it actually, like, kind of seems to collapse down. Like, it actually, like, almost, like, Jack in the Box is down.
Folds up.
When its knees collapse backwards, and the blade and the light whisk over it, and then it kind of like rebounds and springs backwards and does like a flip, and then kind of rolls and then stands up, you know, a good 8 yards away from you, back from the tunnel.
Wow.
So it's very fast, very fast.
And then it kind of looks at you and goes, that's not nice.
I mean, I'm just going to back up. I'm not going to talk to the damn thing.
Okay, so you back up again?
Yeah, I'm staying defensive. I have no conversation with the dude.
Okay.
Is my elbow on the button again? Can I let them know what happened? He's fast as hell.
Yeah, so you put your button...
What the fuck
Your elbow back down there? On the button, and you're like, this thing's fucking fast. You know, kind of thing, and the three of you are hearing this, but unfortunately you're not in a position to really do anything. It looks at you, Roland, and it goes, you should put down that sword. I need you to roll me willpower self-discipline check. You can hear this.
Oh, he's magically trying to get me to put down the sword?
Mm-hmm.
Ew.
And you are resisting its will.
Okay, with the 12?
I think it totally is that thing that's been tracking
it. It is.
Roland,
yes.
You sheathe your holy blade.
Dun dun dun!
And are engulfed in darkness.
It's now pitch black and okay.
Open the door!
Almost immediately after that, you can feel those weird tentacle things kind of like running along your shield. And then, like, kind of, like, going around the shield. Like, it's testing where you are in relation to that shield.
Can I just aggressively shove forward with the shield, trying to hit him with the shield?
Yeah, you can shove it. I need a might check from you.
And that would be strength, I'm assuming?
Yes.
I thought for some reason you were going to say he was running his tentacly fingers over his chest and back. And I was like, oh, God.
I thought phase two.
It's a weird
can I use
finger?
In your rule set, can I use a shield as a weapon? Kind of like get, because he's tall, right? I can kind of like just just jam it forward and try and get the edge like right where I think his head would be.
If you're trying to do damage versus move it,
uh-huh.
I view that as two different things right now. Like, the way you phrased it, I would say that you're trying to push it away from you. Whereas if you're trying to actually, like, hit it and hurt it, that's going to be an attack roll.
Yeah, I want to at least, like, daze the guy with my shield so I can pull my sword back out.
Okay, it would be 3d6 plus 4. Your fighting is 4, right?
Yes. No, my fighting is 3. Can I just lie and say it's 4?
3d6 plus 3, then.
Okay.
Can I just lie and say it's 4?
Double sixes!
Yeah, I got 16 after the plus 3.
Okay. So you actually... I need a roll for this. What would be a shield? I'm going to say it's almost like an improvised weapon. It'd be... Do slash roll 1d6 plus your strength, which I think is a 3 or a 4.
So it's a 2 plus 2. 4. I did 4 damage. Awesome.
He also, does he get stun points for that?
He gets six stun points.
Six stun points? Oh, cool. Let me check out your combat then. Thank you, Zeke. I have 6 stun points?
Yeah.
I want to do lethal blow. Can I do lethal
You're going
blow?
For, like, the full kit and caboodle. There's no skirmishing. Yeah. You're not going to, like, knock it back from you or anything? You're going full ham?
No, it's a damn demon. I want to chop his head off with my shield.
Oh, that's right. You are very in character. Good job. Appreciate it. Yeah, roll me another 2d6.
Okay.
Now I actually have to pull up his character sheet because I wasn't expecting you to fucking go ham on it.
And I have 1 stunt point left, right?
Yep.
You actually you have more. You're a fighter. You get an automatic 1 anytime you do it. So you actually had 7 total stunt points.
And I used so I can do anything with the 2.
So you did.
Well, I don't want to take too much time.
So you could use a mighty blow if you wanted to just do more damage.
No, pierce. you can't do lethal and mighty in the same turn.
Yeah, it specifically says you're not allowed to do both.
Oh, okay.
Should I do knock prone or pierce armor?
Pierce armor would do the damage. It would have the armor that it owns. Knock prone would obviously
it
knock
would increase
it down.
My 6.
And or you could
I'm
do skirmish.
Down.
Okay, to knock it back. Knock down?
Yeah, I want to knock it down. And then next turn, I'm going to freaking chop its head off of my shield.
Maybe you can get your sword out, and then you don't have to use an improvised weapon.
That's smarter. I like that thinking.
You won't
just
be
throwing
able to
that
attack
out there.
You won't be able to attack that turn, but it has to take a full turn to stand up. So
yeah, no, like... I have quick reflexes, so while it's standing up, I can draw my sword.
Okay.
Could you do the... defensive stance or whatever to get an additional thing so
I'm
that
not, I'm out of points. Yeah, sorry.
Well, instead of a knockdown, she's saying, can't you spend the
oh,
two
instead
for
of a knockdown,
a bonus 2 defense? I think there's something.
Well, the
like
knockdown,
that.
I don't know Isn't if it there? Can attack you while you're standing over it. So,
I'm assuming when I knock it down, it's like a minute. It's a step back for me too, right? Like I knock it back a little bit.
Well, it gets knocked down. Skirmishing moves it back from you.
Okay. I mean, I want to knock it to the ground, and then when it takes its turn to stand up, I want to pull my sword out.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Is that a bad idea?
No, you can totally do that. You can actually, in an attack round, you still have, like, a movement.
I can do all 3, because...
So you could draw your sword after pushing it back.
Oh, okay, well, I'm going to push it. I'm going to knock it down.
And then draw your sword.
Oh, no, I see what you're saying. Yeah, knock it down, draw my sword.
Yeah, okay.
And then it's its turn, right?
And then it's his turn.
Do we not... Can we do things right now?
Yeah, are they just standing there?
This is what's going on outside. I'm going to let it do a round, and then we're going to cut back to you guys. Because I wasn't expecting Steven to go, like, full ham on a demon.
Sorry.
We kind of got to do this, like, back and forth struggle. Huh?
Can't he draw... You said he had quick reflexes. He should be able to just draw his weapon.
Oh, that's right. You have quick reflexes, don't you, Steven?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can draw it right
That's
after
a free
you knock
action.
It down.
You should have...
You.
I mean, I'm going to say that
so then
you should have been able...
Can I knock him down, draw it, and do my religion check thing to light it back up?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, and then they can talk for a while.
Give me a faith check.
Where's faith? Willpower?
Yes.
Shit, that's good, right? 15?
Lights and it relights.
Thank okay. God. All right.
So well, it does that.
You guys try and save me.
You hear under, you know, from the knockdown creature, you hear, ah! And then it, you see it, like, jump up, like, almost, like, spring up. Like, in one motion, it springs and goes backwards away from you in a darkness. And it's like, stop attacking me. And then need you to do a willpower self-defense.
Damn it.
Self-defense or self-discipline?
Self-discipline.
I don't have anything. I just have willpower.
Nope. So you
I got a six.
You are willed not to no longer attack it.
For how
okay.
long?
Okay. I have my sword out still, though.
Yes, you do have your sword. The three of you. What are you guys doing? You hear over the intercom. This thing's really fucking fast. And then the intercom shuts off as obviously Roland on the other side, which you don't know, is going ham with a shield.
I'm gonna look for the door release, scurrying around finding that, because it's got to be somewhere, or like trace back the wires from the lock to find out where that release is.
Can you re-describe the room we're in, other than the floodlights that we have apparently pointed as? Like, how big is this room?
Give me one second, guys. My mother just showed up. Since I'm watching her house, I should probably go say hi.
All right.
Hopefully, a pants on.
Versi doesn't wear pants.
I don't know that.
Weren't you guys blinded by the spotlights when you guys hopped through?
Yeah.
Yeah, originally. So I'm assuming my eyes adjusted at this point. So I'm hoping.
What do you guys know about this demon thing that I just shielded?
Nothing.
It was this is the first actual encounter with it. Last time I saw it, it ran away.
I mean, it
well, it tried to. It did the weird finger thing to get you to come to it, and then like it ran away.
Yeah. Beckon
you, and then.
That was the second time I almost got killed.
Well, you like to get yourself almost killed a lot, so.
Apparently.
It seems like it's really just good at kind of getting you to do what it wants. As long as you can keep on the offensive, it's not that bad.
Well, unless you have a low will. Like...
Hey, Versi.
Yeah, I mean, he did force me to do what he wanted twice.
Yeah, they just got back from Vegas. Yep. So I had to say hi to him since Vegas. I'm watching her house. okay. So you're trying to find a wire or something, Flowers? That's what you're looking to do?
Right, so I'm looking at where the lock is, and usually if it's an electronic lock, it's going to have a wire leading to the relay.
Okay, you can see that this panel where everything seems to be running, it's kind of seamless, like there's casing around everything, and it leading into the wall itself. So the wires are running inside of the machine, or inside of the wall.
Can I pop open that control panel?
Roll me a seeing check to see through the blinding light.
God damn it. That's perception, correct?
It is. Nope. Damn it. What are the two other two of you doing?
Can we tell the assholes to turn off the damn lights?
Yeah, roll me a persuasion check to tell them to turn off the damn lights. No response. Light still blinding you. Zeke, you gonna play another song?
No. What kind of? Okay. Can you re-describe the room we're in? Because all I remember is that there are blinding lights. How big is this room, to my knowledge? Do we know how big it is?
The lights that are blinding you seem to be about 20 meters away from you, and they're the giant like spotlight searchlights that like. Are like intended for like sky searches for planes or to like let you know that a big movie's happening kind of thing. Like they're that kind of big lights, the ones that shine on clouds. And those are actually directed at you guys, and that's why you're having so much trouble seeing, is literally you have this like 10,000 lumen light bulb and like a ring of them in a semicircle pointed at you and this door.
Well, let's see. I have tools on me, right?
Yeah, you got plenty of tools.
I want to throw... Can I easily grab one of the various tools in said pack? Like, would it be easy for me to grab one of those?
Yeah.
Okay, I want to take it and throw it at a light.
Awesome. Roll me a accuracy check. This would be your 3d6 plus your accuracy minus 2, because this is a long distance for a throwing item.
3d6 plus my accuracy minus 2. So I rolled an 8.
You wing it, but the blinding light is just really hard, hurting your eyes, and you're not sure where exactly to throw it at, so you just take, you know, a monkey wrench and you just wing that bitch off into somewhere in front of you.
What,
you hear a clanking
sound. How far are the lights from them?
20 meters, which is 10 squares away.
Are we supposed to have a map on the screen?
No.
Because we're... Okay.
This is pure roleplay. I was not intending you guys to really go into combat for this.
Can I walk it? Can I walk towards the lights now?
Absolutely. So are you just walking, or are you kind of... Your full movement?
Yep.
Okay, cool. Anything else that you guys are trying to do? I'm going to say that while, you know, Roland was doing all of that you guys would get like 2 rounds of doing stuff.
We're gonna get 2 rounds.
So is that gonna count as 2 rounds for me then, or
you can move another move and then you'd be right next to a light?
Going to move another move then. I'm moving as far towards those lights,
okay,
as close to those lights as humanly possible.
Yeah, you can move there in 2 movements. So you do one movement, now you have another movement, now you have a major action. You could hit it with like the butt of your gun and possibly break it.
Are they at ground level? Are they raised or
varying? Some are on the ground, some are up on like more like pole type things and aim downward towards the door. That way they can overlap a little bit. You get the feeling that they tried to fit as many of these giant lights as humanly possible into this area, this semicircle, to shine at the door.
How big are these lights again? Like how like rough? Okay, so
basically touch your fingers together and try to make a circle. And that's the size of the light. No, like
using your arms.
My arms, like kind of like me.
So,
like
okay.
This.
Gotcha. Okay.
Like YMCA, except for like
gotcha. Okay.
Making an O.
YOMCA.
YO.
Can I put my jacket over one of these?
That will sizzle the shit out of your jacket, just letting you know.
Okay. Well, then I don't want to do that.
Turn it around? Is it that big?
They're on wheels. I can say that you could turn it. It would take a full action to turn one, though.
Well, shit, can't run over there and spin him around? She's strong.
Yeah.
I'll start trying to turn one around then.
Okay, cool. So you spend your action kind of turning one of these lights. You can also kind of see a little bit better, but there's still like kind of spots from your vision. You're kind of seeing like ghost light from being blinded. And you can see that there's about 10 of these in the area.
And that's with sunglasses on.
Yeah. Roland. So it just told you to stop attacking it. And you obeyed. You stopped moving towards it.
So I physically cannot take a swing at it.
You are not allowed to take a swing at it. You are not allowed to do anything that might, in your mental capacity, deem yourself as trying to attack or harm it. But you're allowed to do anything besides that.
Okay. I'm just in a hallway with a demon, right?
Yeah.
And I don't have anything except like a blanket, so I don't really have any other options besides taking a swing at it, which I can't do. Can I just step back, get back in my defensive stance, and start praying?
Sure. You're actually gonna like pray?
Well, I mean, can I? Well, I think that for my character, my version of praying would kind of just be talking to my dead wife.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, but in like a... So, do I need to give you a speech about what he's saying, or can he just be...
I kind of want to know what exactly... What's the subject matter for that? Like, you don't have to, like, actually, like, roleplay to me what the whole conversation you have with your dead wife, but... Like...
He's kind of just asking for strength and saying, you know, I
okay.
Don't want to fail you, I don't want to take this demon out.
Gotcha. You can see as you back up that it slowly starts to move forward. and it says, I just want to talk.
Oh, well, I mean, I feel like for the story, I should talk to the guy. My character would totally not be cool with that.
No, you can sit there and do nothing, because you're kind of in the position where you're not allowed to, so you can just keep praying and not respond
I want to hit the intercom with my sword. I want to hit the intercom with my shield, or my elbow, not any weapon, sorry. And just let them know that he just wants to talk.
So you interrupt your praying, and so you stop your praying, and you like say, like, it just wants to talk?
It still seems out of character, but yeah. I'm not going to, like, I'm going to say he says he just wants to talk, because I don't believe him.
Okay. At which point, you all can kind of hear this. This is when you're, like, turning the thing and all that. I forgot to ask, Kiro and Flowers, I forgot to ask you your second round.
I'm going to stay by the door.
Okay. So you're going to stay near the keypad? And look
for a manual. Yeah.
Okay. Ren, what were you going to be doing? You had this flaming sword ready.
I'll try and... How many lights were there again?
10. Aimed at you, now 9 because of Zeke turning one of them.
Did he see anything when he turned it around?
That I told him, that's where he was able to figure out that there's 10 of them, that some are up higher than lower all that. Because right now they basically see this giant blanket of blinding light pointed at them.
I'm just kind of like, if I run over there and turn another one or whatever, or knock it down, it's still going to be really bright.
Yeah.
What exactly is around the door? Like, what? There's buttons. There's, like, a keypad.
There's a key panel. There's the door. And then there's metal wall. And then, like, underground, under your feet has been, like, a metal kind of mesh paneling. But that's really the extent of
what... Is there, like,
a
tunnel underneath the mesh paneling, or is it...
No. It's just kind of like that, like, slightly, like, raised mesh, and then it's steel underneath.
I don't know. I can't really do anything. Can I hold my turn,
yeah.
I guess?
Yeah, no problem.
And I can't do anything.
Mm-hmm. Okay, back to Roland then. You can see that it slowly walks back to, and it starts kind of like innately just touching around the light and feeling, and it's like, this would be easier if you put away your sword.
Is that an option?
It's asking.
Command?
No, it's not a command. It's asking.
Well, fuck no.
Okay.
What do you mean?
Well, fuck that shit. Yeah.
It was asking.
I'm sorry.
It's trying to hold a conversation.
If this was a single player game, I would say, you know, fuck this guy and I'd take a swing as soon as I can.
You
but
choose
that's not
of the three
us.
Options, go fuck so, yourself.
Yeah, I mean,
okay.
I'm going to say, all right, you got 10 seconds. Yeah. I'm not putting the sword away, but you got 10 seconds. What do you have to say? And I'm just kind of biding time before I feel like I can hit him again.
It you can see that it focuses.
Oh wait, sorry, I'm still holding the intercom.
Yeah, I know. I figured you were. Okay. You can feel that it's eyeless face looks at you. It kind of get that feeling like it's looking at you even though it doesn't have eyes.
I look away from its face.
Yeah, and it goes, just a message. Beware. The darkness. And then it slowly starts stepping back.
Oh, are you kidding me? Does it just leave?
That was it.
Awesome. So I wasted 45 minutes.
It was so worth it. You know it.
Okay.
Wait. Can you be like...
That's it?
He's just are you going to say
be
that's
like,
it?
Hey, what are you saying? Like...
Do you want to like comment to it? I mean, you've been less than receptive to this thing.
Yeah, no, I don't like the guy. No, I mean, if he's leaving, he's leaving.
It's slowly slinking back from you.
Do I feel like I can hit it yet?
No, you do not feel like you can hit it.
Well, then, yeah, I'm just going to stand there and watch them go.
Okay.
They can...
Cool.
But they heard all that. It goes into the darkness.
The three of you. Nate, if you're going to be searching, I need another seeing check. Zach, okay. You're still turning lights, correct?
Yes.
You can turn two more lights in your turn.
There's nobody up the hallway?
Not that you can see.
Everybody just fucking ran?
I can see good.
You can see good. And you could remove a panel where they're to see the wires of this.
I'm going to do that.
What are you trying to do with wires?
I'm going to try to short circuit it.
He's going
to
lick them.
What would I think you should roll for something like that?
He needs to roll a hack check.
I don't have that.
I know you.
Yeah, you know, you gotta stick your USP penis.
Nope, that was
USB
different.
Penis.
Different one. That's a different campaign.
Steven does not know the inside joke of the USB penis, so he's like,
"Why didn't you just say US penis?"
USB penis. Is what I meant.
That would be an intelligence engineering check to know what you're exactly supposed to be. Pulling.
Hey, I have that.
Do you?
I have engineering.
Oh, that's right, because you learned like disarming bombs or something was like the concept of that.
Does he have any intelligence? Is the better question.
No, I don't. So this could be rough. And
give
here
it
we
a
go.
Swing.
Fuck me.
That nine.
Wow.
So are you cutting wires or what exactly are you? I mean, like, are you like trying to go into swap mode where you're like, is it the red wire or the blue wire?
I was trying to reverse engineer it the first time so that I don't fuck up the door permanently.
Okay, so like, what exactly are you doing? Because like, I kind of want to know.
Test. I don't know how to describe it. I'm like testing it without breaking the door. I'm like looking how it's built so I can try.
Okay,
to
so you're
figure
like
out
trying to like trace wires.
Yeah.
Okay, so like you're kind of like trying to trace wires, and you just keep like at a certain point, like the kind of the light's getting a little bit to you, and like you're trying to see it, and like you realize that like one's gray, one's black, and one's white, and they all seem to just kind of like mesh together in colors, and so you're like, fuck, and like you can't focus correctly on trying to figure out where certain wires
lead.
Ren, what are you doing?
I'm gonna ask him over the intercom, is it still there?
Okay, did the lights come back on as it shrunk away?
It hasn't yet, but I was about to say that after you feel the hold of you to not attack it, slowly start to kind of wear off, where like you kind of have that action to like, and that anger to go after it, and that's when the light comes on, where over your...
Okay, I wanna chase it into the darkness. No.
That's what I would do.
Leroy!
Yeah, I'm gonna say it looks like he left after he gave us our message, but it looks like, because he's obviously a deceptive dude, it looks like he left and the lights are back on. So why don't you just ask them to open the door?
There's nobody here. It's
well,
weird.
You could, I mean, can I hit the, can, then, wouldn't they be able to hear me like the way they did before?
Yeah.
I'm assuming they're
I'm
listening,
assuming,
whoever
yeah.
they are.
At that point, this is the first time that you hear Abigail say anything, and she says, "You hear that, you fucks? Open the fucking door!" At which point you hear the and the door slowly starts to open. Roland, do you dive through, or are you waiting for like the door to open all the way?
No, I'm cool, calm, and collected. I'm just waiting. Okay. Well, not until it's open fully, but like once I can just kind of step through.
Okay, so like at the moment that you can easily like step backwards, you do. And the moment that they see you, like, take that step back, you hear the door slowly start to close again.
Is there, like, viscera or, like, gore on top of my shield?
No, you did, like, just a resounding, like, you know, push, you know, kind of,
like... like, cut into him. Okay.
Yeah, you didn't, like, cut into him or anything like that, but you definitely, like, you know, gave him a serious bump on the head. It was the equivalent of what I was thinking you kind of went for.
Okay.
Hiss!
Yeah.
It's got jazz hands. It literally has jazz hands because the finger is like.
Oh dear. Oh dear.
Okay.
I want to just describe to them what I saw.
Yeah, okay. So are you doing this all in the middle of like a strobe light or, you know, a giant like spotlight thing? Because like you basically like walk through this door and then like you're hit with like this blinding light. like around you.
Oh, I thought I was still facing towards.
Yeah, you're facing away, but like from behind you, you just get flooded with this light. And then the door closes, and then you're like basically facing this like sheet of like
metal. Oh, so I don't even know where they are. Okay, well, I'm gonna keep my shield up, lock my eyes, and turn around.
Okay, so he's kind of got a shield, kind of like as you know, covering his eyes, kind of thing, and he's like kind of looking. And so like you can't see, but you can see the direction that the light's coming from, and you can kind of look over and squinting, you can see Ren and Flowers. You don't have any idea where Zeke is. Zeke, at this point, you probably turned about half the lights.
Woohoo!
Away.
Oh, he was still going that whole time?
Yeah.
Yep.
The only ones that you haven't turned are the big ones that are, like, raised, because those you probably would need help with to actually move. You've been turning the ones that seemed easy for you to turn. So, what's going on with you guys? I mean... Abigail's okay. Walking towards the lights at this point.
She's a bitch.
I've got to put my sword away and be like, are you okay? Like, all concerned and shit.
Oh, okay, that's a good... I'm going to say what happened, basically. Just a quick rundown of, yeah, I'm fine, but there was a sketchy-ass thing that said that we need to worry about the dark. And on that note, I'm going to keep my flaming sword out. Is there a time limit to that?
Not reasonably. Not in any noticeable amount.
And you told us what it looked like, right?
Yeah, I'm assuming I just gave a brief rundown. I don't want to... But yeah, like a military briefing, just every pertinent information you need.
Oh. I'm gonna be like, I'm gonna look at Flowers and Zeke like, oh shit.
That's why we've taken so long.
That's what you say to me?
Yep.
Or to Abigail, probably. In general. Yeah, she's the nasty one. Yeah.
Yep.
She's actually gotten to the point where you are, and she kind of turns back. She's like, come on. And as to being late, understandable now, but we need to find out what's going on here.
Well, I feel like we should probably leave those lights facing at the door, like in case.
Yeah, she doesn't help you with those lights.
We just turned like two of them or something.
Yeah, I should leave the rest of them at the door.
Total five of them. Away.
Oh, did he? Okay.
Yep.
Basically, I like that, though, because we need to worry about darkness. Leave half and half so that we're protected from the back, but we can see ahead.
Well, there's light beyond. You just haven't...
Okay.
Like, there's
those lights
of,
are
like...
purposely so if some stranger comes in and blinds them and they have a attack of opportunity. So...
Or it's protecting from the darkness.
Yeah.
About two.
So, from that point, Abigail strides on, and she's like, come on, guys, we gotta figure out what's going on here.
I proceed to turn one light back around.
Back towards the door?
Yes.
Okay. So now there's six lights facing the door. What are the other three of you come along, I'm assuming?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna end it a little bit early tonight. Main reason being is the next section's probably going to take an hour and a half to 2 hours, and I don't want to start something and cut it off in the middle. I wasn't expecting that entire scene to take quite as long as it did.
It was epic, and you know it.
Sorry. But it was good. I thoroughly enjoyed everything that went on.
I'm okay with it.
And yeah, I was okay with everything. Just so you know, Steven, like, that was completely like reasonable. I was kind of surprised. I'm like, damn, that's kind of like gung-ho, and then I was like, of all the characters, I would normally expect Flowers to do that, but I'm like, actually, your character is now the one I fully expect to never deal with a demon. I was like, that's the worst character this demon could have wanted to talk to.
I didn't even think talking was an option. I thought I was holding them off until they got the door open and we were going to take them out.
I thought we were too, but we couldn't get the fucking door open.
Yeah. That was the problem.